Hi guys, today I'm going to be showing you how I file down my almond shaped nails to a square shape. I've had my nails almond shape already for about 4 months, and I decided because fall started, I wanted to go for the square shape again. So they were pretty long already, so I'm going to show you how exactly I cut them down and filed them square. I'm going to begin by placing my clipper, my nail clipper, about halfway down my nail, and I'm just going to remove the little tip left over, sort of like I'm going a little bit higher than what I actually want my fingernail to be, because I can always file down so that it could match the nails on my other hand. So basically that's what I'm doing. I had my nails already long in this almond shape for about 4 months. And now that I filed down my nails square, I've had them like this for a couple of days, and I miss my almond shaped nails. I really do. It's just a very easy nail shape to maintain. A lot easier than square nails. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the nail file. And as you can see here, I'm zigzagging back and forth. If you have short nails, definitely just file towards one direction. But because my nails are long and I don't want to take forever filing my nails, I'm just going back and forth zigzagging, and now I'm using my buffing block, just cleaning out the nail's free edge, and I'm just going to compare it to the nail on the other side, and they're exactly the same. So I'm just going to continue with the same pattern over all of my fingernails, and here you can see me again zigzagging back and forth, but the last files I give my nail are going towards one direction only. The last files. Like I said, I don't want to take all day filing my nails. This is a pretty quick process. Here I'm comparing my nails and I'm happy with the length they both have. So I'm just going to buff out the corners so that I have nice clean lines. Also, the back of my fingernail has nail dust residue. So I'm just going to remove it with the nail file and file it down again and just move on to the following nail. So it's basically the same process. Filing, removing the nail dust residue from the back of the fingernail, and just using the buffing block to have a clean, nice line over the nail's free edge. And that's basically it. As you can see, this is a really quick process. And like I was telling you guys, the almond shaped nails are even easier than this. I didn't bend my nails, not even once during the 4 months. And when I have square nails, I do notice that it's a lot more maintenance, and I do bump them into things a lot more. I suppose because there's more nail at the tip. But I absolutely loved the almond shaped nails. I'm thinking maybe of going back to my almond shaped nails during summer and keeping them square during winter, but I'm not sure because I did also miss my square nails. So here I'm just working on my pinky fingernail, just going towards one direction because I didn't have a lot of length to get rid of on this one. So I'm just filing it down little by little. I'm gonna buff it down from the corners. And that's it. My nails are ready to apply an oil. Use any oil of your choice. Nails love this. And also always remember to apply the oil over the back of your fingernails. And you can definitely do this on top of polished nails. If your nails are polished, of course, you don't do it over your entire nail, only over your cuticle area. So I'm doing the same thing to both my fingernails. I'm doing it to both sides of my fingernails, both hands. I hope you guys understand what I'm trying to say. And I'm just doing the back of my fingernails as well on this side as well. Back and front. And now I'm just going to close the top because I've had so many accidents. I always make sure to first close the top. And then what's next is just to massage that oil in. Your nails will love you for this. You will see a great payoff when you do this to your fingernails. Nails grow super fast with this technique. And that's it. All I'll have left to do is to apply a base coat, any base coat of your choice that works great for you. And I do wait for the oil to penetrate, but if you notice that your nail polish peels off easily, definitely wash your hands before applying your base coat. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.